For this demonstration, we'll show how to add a pressure flow bridge to our SRH 2D model. We will also show a 3D bridge in SMS. To add a pressure flow bridge, we need to add a pair of arcs to our BC coverage. To begin with, let's duplicate the existing BC coverage. We will rename this coverage to BC Structures. This way, we will have one coverage with the structures and one without. To define the pressure flow bridge, we will add arcs upstream and downstream of the bridge deck. To create these arcs, it is helpful to have both elements and elevation contours turned on in the display options. We will create these arcs so that they will snap to the edges of the elements that align with the bridge deck boundary. We'll begin by creating an arc on the upstream edge. We should be sure to extend the arcs into the embankments on both ends. Next, we create the downstream arc. We need to create this arc in the same direction as we created the upstream arc. The elements between these arcs will be defined as those where pressure flow will be computed by SRH 2D. Next, we will assign the attributes for the bridge. First, let's select the upstream arc. Note here in the status window that the ID for this arc is 3. Now we also select the downstream arc, then right-click and select Assign BC. Let's look at the BC type options. Note that since we have selected two arcs, there are now additional options available for structures. For defining a pressure flow bridge, we select Pressure. Now let's be sure that the upstream and downstream arcs are defined correctly. Note the upstream arc is 3, which, as noted previously, is the ID for the upstream arc. If it is wrong, we could quickly change it here. Next, we'll assign the attributes. We'll select flat as the ceiling type and leave the units as feet. We then specify a ceiling elevation. We use the same value for both the upstream and downstream edges. Finally, we specify a Manning's roughness for the underside of the bridge. We'll select 0.05. Note here at the bottom is where we could specify overtopping for the bridge. This brings up additional parameters to define the overtopping. This is basically defined as a weir, so we enter crest elevation, length, and other weir parameters. We will cover weir attributes in a later part of this lesson. We won't include overtopping in this model run. We now need to replace the current BC coverage in the simulation with the one we just created. Let's start by duplicating the existing simulation. We'll rename it Proposed Structures. This simulation is identical to the existing simulation, including the model control parameters. Next, we need to replace the BC coverage with the one just created. We right-click on the BC coverage and select Remove. Next, we drag the new BC structures coverage into the new simulation. We are now ready to run the model. To do this, we would simply select Save Project Simulation and Run. We won't actually run the model for this demo. Next, we'll quickly show how to define a 3D bridge in SMS. First, we'll create a new coverage and assign it as a 3D bridge type under Models. We'll leave the name as 3D bridge. We now create two arcs along the edges of the bridge deck, similar to those we created for the pressure flow bridge. Next, we define the bridge profiles. Right-click on the 3D bridge coverage and select Edit Bridge. Here we define the top profile of the bridge and the upstream and downstream profiles for the low chord. We'll create a simple sloped bridge. We'll first enter two values for the top profile. Then we'll enter two values for the upstream profile. By default, the downstream profile is the same as the upstream. If we want a different profile for the downstream profile, we check this box and define it separately. If we check this box, then SMS automatically saves the 3D bridge for us when we click OK. SMS will save and add the 3D bridge to the display. Let's zoom in and rotate to see the bridge. Now we'll read in the 3D bridge previously created for this crossing with a more complex low chord profile. 3D bridges can also be created to represent piers. We will read in another 3D bridge representing one of the piers. In addition to providing a 3D visualization of the bridge, the 3D bridge can be used to define the ceiling elevations. To do this, we'll right-click on the simulation and select Model Control. Here we select the checkbox, Use Pressure Ceiling, to use the 3D bridge to define the ceiling elevations for the bridge. We also click this button to specify which coverage defines the ceiling elevations. This concludes the demonstration for defining a pressure flow bridge in SMS, as well as showing the 3D bridge options. In the exercise for this lesson, you will define a pressure flow bridge and run a model with the bridge included.